Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Sacred Guard. Welcome back to Undertale. Now, last episode, we just got started on the game, and we end up coming over here to this, this little house right here, this Toriel's place. Stayed here, and says she has something, like a surprise for us, so let's go ahead. Do you smell that? Surprise! It is a butterscotch cinnamon pie. Ooh, that sounds good. I actually want to try that. I thought we might celebrate your arrival. I want you to have a nice time living here.
Aww.
So I will hold off on snail pie for tonight.
Now why is that? What, is that like if you have nothing else, you just resort to that?
Here, I have another surprise for you.
Let me walk around the house for a little bit first. I'll be right there. The heck? Are these like dead flowers or is it? Seems like the right size for Toria. Yes, it does. There's some white fur stuck in the drain. Inside the cupboard, ginger critter, cookie cutters and gingerbread monsters. What a nice smell. Too hot to eat, though. Stovetop is very clean. Toria must use fire magic instead. Okay. For some reason, there's brand name chocolate bar in the fridge. Alright. Whoop, no. The fire isn't burning hot, just pleasantly warm. You could put your hand inside. Wow. Okay, I'll look at the rest of the stuff later.
This is it. A room of your own. I hope you like it. Well, thank you.
Oh, she's petting his head! She's petting my head! So cute!
Is something burning? Make yourself at home.
Of course. Wow, okay, I really love this game. It's so adorable. Oh my god, this game is so adorable. Okay. Oh, I was looking in the comments and whatnot. Somebody told me to look like, play a certain way, and I do plan to. You have seen this type of plant before, but do not know its name. Really? Have I? Okay. Is this Toriel's room? It's a regular old bucket of snake. Okay, that's completely normal. It's Toriel's diary. No, I don't want to read her diary. I don't want to read her diary. I won't read it. Maybe I'll read a little bit. Read the circle passage, yes. You read the passage. Why did the skeleton want a friend? Because she was feeling bonely. The rest of the page is filled with jokes of a similar caliber. This is puns! Definitely bigger than a twin-size bed. Okay. Encyclopedia of Subterranean Plants. You open to the middle. Typha, a group of wetland flowering plants with brown oblong seed pods, known more commonly as water sausages. Okay. You peek inside. Scan the- Wait, not- It's Toriel's Sockture. What? What? Why would you go and do something like that to be gay? Like, what the heck? So like, oh, you peek inside, scan- Like, you made me think that, what, am I looking at her underwear drawer or something? Come on, now. It's the sock drawer. There's nothing scandalous about that. There is nothing that is sexually appealing and scandalous as looking in a woman's sock drawer. Okay. You can't stop looking at the sock. Why? What? The cactus. Truly the most sundari of plants. What? What does that even mean? What? The sundari of plants? I know what sundari means, but come on now. Inside the drawer are flower seeds and some broken crayons. Oh, it is a water sausage. That's okay. Room under renovations. Why? It's you! Yay, it's me! It's Vaughn! Hey! Okay, so Toriel's doing something, so I guess this is my room. Oh. Box of kids' shoes and disparity of sizes. What, you didn't know what to pick out for me? An empty photo frame, it's really dusty. look at these cool toys. They don't interest you at all. I guess I just go to sleep now. Okay.
She left a slice of pie for me.
Got a slice of butterscotch cinnamon pie.
Aw.
I'll turn the light on. Alright, Toriel, where are you? Oh, there she is.
Up already, I see.
Is she wearing glasses?
I want to know how glad I am to have someone here. There are so many old books I want to share. I want to show you my favorite bug hunting spot.
Well, that sounds nice.
I've also prepared a curriculum for your education. This may come as a surprise to you, but I have always wanted to be a teacher. Actually, perhaps that isn't very surprising. Still...
That little pouty face, she's been like, still?
I am glad to have you living here. Oh, did you want something? What is it?
Thought I heard something. Nothing. When can I go home? I don't wanna leave. I wanna stay here! Is there a different ending where, like, I don't try to leave at all and I just, like, stay here with Toriel forever? And honestly, I think that would be the better ending.
What? This is your home now.
I know, but the game is making me say this.
Would you like to hear about this book I am reading? It is called 72 Uses for Snails. How about it?
Sure, I guess.
Here's an exciting snail fact. Did you know that snails sometimes flip their digestive systems as they mature?
Did they really? I honestly have no idea.
Interesting. How do I exit the ruins? I have something to do. Stay here.
What? Hey, wait! Toriel! Wait a minute! Where'd she go? She in here? No. Is she in her room? No. Can I call her? Nobody picked up. What? God dang it. Okay, let's check downstairs. The atmosphere just changed drastically. Okay.
You wish to know how to return home, do you not? Ahead of us lies the end of the ruins.
Okay.
A one-way exit to the rest of the underground. I'm going to destroy it. No one will ever be able to leave again.
You don't really have to go that far. I mean, I honestly don't really want to leave, but the game is making me choose.
Now be a good child and go upstairs.
I want to listen to her, but I want to know what... God!
Every human that falls down here meets the same fate.
What fate? What fate do they meet?
I have seen it again and again. They come. They leave. They die. You naive child. If you leave the ruins, they, Asgore, will kill you.
Who's Asgore?
I am only protecting you, do you understand? Go to your room.
I want to listen, but I have to know, is this going to affect the game if I do this? I have no idea. I want to listen to her, but I want to know!
Do not try to stop me. This is your final warning.
No, don't do the final warning thing. That means something bad's going to happen. Every time when something does the final warning thing, something bad always happens. Do I go? Do I stay? Do I go? Do I stay? Do I go? Please don't be mad at me, Toriel. I want to know!
You want to leave so badly? You're just like the others.
The others? Well, she said there haven't been many humans that fall down here. Did she even talk about the other kids that came down?
There is only one solution to this. Prove yourself.
What? Prove to me you are strong enough to survive. What? No! 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 I don't want to fight her! Run! I'm out of here!
That is right. Go upstairs.
No! I don't want to fight her! I don't want to fight her! Don't make me fight her, please! God dang it.
Will anything really change if I just go upstairs? I honestly just want to stay upstairs! I don't want to leave her! She looks so lonely! I mean, she's got those, like, other little monsters around and whatnot, but, like, I don't really think, like, they're really friends. I mean, she didn't like the frog, for one thing.
I don't want to fight.
Already? What will it take for you to learn your lesson?
I don't want to fight you. Turia blocks the way. Talk, let's talk. I'm gonna talk it out.
You couldn't think of any conversation topics.
Whoa. Okay, Tori, please calm down. We tried to think of something to say again, but... God dang it! Tori, help, please!
Ironically, talking does not seem to be the solution to the situation.
Really?
Oh, I'm dead. I'm dead.
Can I spare you? God dang it. Spare.
Oh god, no! Okay, I am so dead. I'm so dead. I'm so dead.
Is she not attacking me? Her attacks are avoiding me! She's deliberately avoiding me! Oh, she doesn't want to kill me! Oh, that makes so much more sense!
Toya, you really are a lot more kind-hearted than I was let on.
What are you doing?
I'm sparing you, I don't want to fight. I like this music, too, like, it's so dramatic, like, it sounds... Like, it sounds like something that could be your tragedy. It's like, one way or another, this is gonna be tragic. That's what it sounds like.
Attack or run away?
I'm not doing either. I'm going to attack you, I'm going to attack you heart. With feels.
What are you proving this way?
I'm proving that what you're teaching me is the proper method. You taught me to show mercy. That's what I'm doing.
Fight me or leave.
I'm not doing either. I won't fight you no matter what you say. You're not hitting me, so I'm fine.
Stop it.
No, I won't. You can't make me.
Stop looking at me that way.
Oh, her face getting sadder. Sorta.
Go away. Oh, now that's just rude. Don't say that to me. Come on.
Come on, you're not gonna hit me. You don't want to hit me.
You know this is the right thing I'm doing. I'm just doing what you taught me.
I know you want to go home, but please, go upstairs now.
Oh, I'm so sad.
I promise I will take good care of you here.
I know you would. I know you would, but the game is making me try to leave.
I know we do not have much, but we can have a good life here. Why are you making this so difficult? Please, go upstairs. Pathetic, is it not? I cannot save even a single child. No, I understand. You would just be unhappy trapped down here. The ruins are very small once you get used to them. It would not be right for you to grow up in a place like this. My expectations, my loneliness, my fear. For you, my child,
I will put them aside, like a good mother would.
If you truly wish to leave the ruins, I will not stop you. However, when you leave, please do not come back.
What?
I hope you understand.
Oh, she hugged me. Oh my god, it feels.
Goodbye, my child.
Tori, no, please. Come with me. You can come with me. You can make sure that I'm okay. You don't have to. You don't have to do that. You can just come with me. It'd be so much better. I mean, if you're there with me, you can make sure that I'm fine. You can make sure that this Asgore person doesn't get to me. We'd be perfectly fine together. Can I go see her again? She's not here. She's gone. She's gone. Oh. Toriel. Please answer the phone. Mama, please.
I was not prepared for any of this. Not at all.
I guess I can just keep going forward. That's all I can do.
She won't pick up the phone.
I want to talk to her again.
I want to flirt!
I want to do something. I want to hear her voice again. Is this going to be like this for the rest of the game? I'm literally not able to come back to her?
Oh, it's you. Flower who tried to frickin' kill me off right at the start of the game.
Clever. Very clever. You think you're really smart, don't you?
Yeah, I do. I mean, I can be pretty stupid sometimes, but I think I'm smart.
In this world, it's kill or be killed. So you were able to play by your own rules. You spared the life of a single person. I bet you feel really great. You didn't kill anybody this time.
Well, duh, that's what I was taught. I was taught not to kill.
But what will you do if you meet a relentless killer? You'll die, and you'll die, and you'll die. Until you tire of trying. What will you do then? Will you kill out of frustration? Or will you give up entirely on this world? And let me inherit the power to control it.
You're not inheriting anything. You're just a flower.
I am the prince of this world's future. Don't worry, my little monarch. My plan isn't regicide.
Wait, what does that mean? I don't know what that means.
This is so much more interesting.
Oh. Yeah, well, you can go away. Flowey, just get out of here.
Toriel. I don't want to leave her. She's so lonely. She probably doesn't even have any kids. I'd be her kid. She kept calling me her child. She had the bedroom ready. I mean, probably for like the other kids who came down, but she probably doesn't even have any children. God damn it. That was like, so sad. Okay, I'll go.
I guess that means we're actually starting the game now. That was just like the tutorial of the game. Wait. Well played, Mr. Toby Fox. Can I go back? Come on, please let me go back. Why is it a one-way exit? Huh? There's a camera hidden in the bushes. What? I thought this was a rock. Okay. what he picked up. Alright, I guess I'm all on my own now. I do like how this game, like, has things set up, though. Like, it's really messing with your... Okay, that wasn't broken before. Like, this game is really messing with my emotions, and I really love how things are playing out so far, and I'm really looking forward to the rest of the game. Hey! Okay, it's really messing with my emotions, and I'm looking forward to how the rest of the game will turn out. Is something gonna get me? The music's amping up. I can't move. I can't move. Hi! Hello! Human. Don't you know how to greet a new pal? Turn around and shake my hand. Okay. You're not gonna kill me, are you? You're not gonna... Okay. Okay, let me give a voice to this guy. Oh god. This is a it's a skeleton. And the way the music sounds, okay. I gotta think here. Ah, the old whoopee cushion in the hand trick. It's always funny. Anyways, you're a human, right? That's hilarious. I'm Sans. Sans the skeleton. I'm actually supposed to be on watch for humans right now. Okay, well, you've seen me now. But, you know, I don't really care about capturing anybody. Just wanna sit back, lay back, watch some TV, maybe have a bit of popcorn, you know, the works. Now, my brother, Papyrus, he's a human hunting fanatic. What, does he like have a family of fonts? Because I actually recognize those names right off the bat. Hey, actually, I think that's him over there. I have an idea. Go through this gate thingy. Yeah, go right through. My bro made the bars too wide to stop anyone. Alright. Quick, behind that conveniently shaped lamp. Oh my god, that is very convenient. I'm looking at it and myself and holy crap. Like, what? Oh god. I like this music, holy crap. Okay, I can tell this guy's a complete badass. Sup, bro? Okay. Okay, he kinda reminds me of Skeletor, but I don't exactly have a good Skeletor voice, so,
You know what's up, brother! Ah, this is my Merrick voice from Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged series! Curse you, Pharaoh! You know what's up, brother! It's been 8 days and you still haven't recalibrated your puzzles! You just hang around outside your station, like a lazy bones! What are you even doing?
Staring at this lamp. It's really cool. Do you want to look? No, don't look at the lamp! You're gonna rat me out! You're ratting me out!
No! I don't have time for that! What if a human comes through here? I want to be ready! I will be the one! I must be the one! I will capture a human! Then I, the great Papyrus, not that meddlesome Yugi Moto and his little friends, will get all the things I utterly deserve! Respect! Recognition!
I like this guy.
I will finally be able to join the Royal Guard! People will ask to be my friend! I will bathe in a shower of kisses every morning!
Maybe this lamp will help you- Stop ratting me out, Sans!
Sans! You're not helping, you lazy bones! All you do is sit and boondoggle!
Boondoggle? Yeah, I'm gonna look that up. I wanna find out what that means. Oh, okay, so it's like another word for lazy. Alright, like, sit and be lazy.
You get lazier and lazier by the day.
Hey, take it easy. I've gotten a ton of work done today. A skeleton. Even added the rim shot, but it's...
Sons!
Come on, you're smiling.
I know, and I hate it! Why does someone as great as me have to do so much to get some recognition?
Wow, sounds like you're really working yourself. Is he gonna do it? Down to the bone. Wow, like, come on. You know it's good laughs.
Ah, I will attend to my puzzles. As for your work, put a little more backbone into it.
Okay, so he is like Skeletor. Oh my god. I love these two! I haven't even gotten that far. This is the second episode of the game, and I'm already in love with these two. Like, holy crap. Okay, you can come out now.
God, for the frick's sake, why did you keep trying to rat me out?
What's this? Some sort of checkpoint sensory station, but there are bottles of ketchup, mustard, and relish sitting inside. What is it, like a hot dog stand? You ought to get going. He might come back. And if he does, you'll have to sit through more of my hilarious jokes. Honestly, I feel like I want to, but at the same time I don't, because puns. What's the holdup? Look, there's nothing to be afraid of. It's just a dark cavern filled with skeletons and horrible monsters.
Yeah, nothing to be afraid of. Just a conveniently shaped lamp.
Actually, hey, hate to bother you, but can you do me a favor? I was thinking, my brother's been kinda down lately. He's never seen a human before, and seeing you, you might just make his day. Don't worry, he's not dangerous. Even if he tries to be. Thanks a million. I'll be up ahead.
But you went backwards.
Oh my god, okay, I love this game.
The convenience of that lamp still fills you with determination. Yeah, that was a very convenient lamp. Holy crap.
And I'll never be able to see Toriel again.
Game, why'd you make me do that?
I wanna see her again.
I think that'll actually be enough for now. I'm really enjoying this. I love these two characters, especially Papyrus is my kind of guy.
I mean, he's a little cocky, yeah, but he's not the bad kind of cocky. He's like the kind of cocky that is like, you can't help but smile at it. So, I'm gonna stop it right here. Next time on Undertale, I'm gonna explore the area and then I'm gonna let Papyrus capture me so he can be able to achieve his dreams. See you guys then.
Do it!